A Czech prisoner has been jailed for 4 years for terrorism, offenses which he tried to stage as jihadist attacks. Jeremiah Borden,
71,
failed to race to block railway lines and left messages at the scene, proclaiming, Allahu Akbar, oh, God is great. In Arabic, 2 passenger trains hit the trees, but nobody was injured. On top of his conviction, the court ordered psychiatric treatment for the far-right sympathizer. He said he hoped to spread fear of Muslim migrants. I did not want to commit terror. I wanted to resist it, he reportedly told the regional court in Prague. Bode also said he was confused by blood pressure medication he was taking. The retired electrician left the trees on tracks near the city of Mladiboleslav, about 30 miles, 50 km, north of Prague in 2017. 9 passengers were on board the first train, while the second with 6 passengers and 3 staff hit the tree at 80 km each. An expert reportedly said it was lucky the trains did not derail. The notes he left at the scene of the crime suggested future attacks on Czech soil and called for violence against Czech unbelieving Czechs. News website Novinky CZ reports. Local media pointed out the irony of an elderly Czech man, seemingly radicalized by anti-migrant rhetoric, being among the first in the country to be convicted of terror offenses. A popular tourist attraction has become the latest Chinese company to show solidarity with Huawei's chief finance officer, Meng Wanzhou, who was arrested in Canada on 1 December. Shannon Mountain Scenic Park in eastern Henan province said it would waive the $9.65 ticket fee for anyone carrying a Huawei phone. Ms. Meng, who was given bail in Canada, faces extradition to the United States on charges of breaking Iran sanctions. Her case has upped tensions with China. U.S. Huawei phones should grant photos on the mountain, a notice on the Shan'an Park's social media account said. We wish friends around the world who support Huawei success in bliss. The offer would last until 29 December, the South China Morning Post reported, but it was met with some criticism among China's social media users, who claimed it was discriminatory. Huawei phone owners are being offered other enticements too. They can get a 20% discount at a bar in Beijing. Seen in Beijing, bring a Huawei phone and get 20% off. Similar to this story, we covered yesterday https://coqxl1ipqlpic.twitter.com/love. End of Twitter post by @loshinji. At least one firm has threatened to penalize anyone buying Apple products. A few days ago, Manpada Shenzhen, based LED display manufacturer, offered subsidies to any employees buying Huawei phones. It also pledged to fine anyone who bought an Apple iPhone. United States prosecutors alleged Ms. Meng,
46,
used a Huawei subsidiary called Skycom to evade sanctions on Iran between 2009 and 2014. They also allege she publicly misrepresented Skycom as being a separate company from Huawei, and that she deceived banks about the true relationship between the two companies. Ms. Meng, who is the daughter of Huawei's founder, has denied any wrongdoing and said she will contest the allegations. Life of Huawei's high-flying heiress. The United States has been investigating the Chinese telecoms giant the world's second largest smartphone maker, since 2016, believing that it used Skycom to bring the United States manufacturing equipment and millions of dollars in transactions to Iran in violation of sanctions. Ms. Mann's detention comes amid an increasingly acrimonious trade dispute between Washington and Beijing. China is angry at her detention, saying she has not violated any laws. Beijing has threatened severe consequences unless Canada releases the executive. Since her arrest, two Canadians, a former diplomat and a businessman, have been detained in China on suspicion of harming national security. United States President Donald Trump said last week that he might intervene in the United States Justice Department's case against Ms. Mann if it would serve national security interests or help achieve a trade deal with China. If I think it's good for what will be certainly the largest trade deal ever made, which is a very important thing, what's good for national security, I would certainly intervene if I thought it was necessary, he told Reuters news agency. Canada reacted by urging Mr. Trump not to politicize the situation. Our extradition partners should not seek to politicize the extradition process or use it for ends other than the pursuit of justice, Foreign Minister Chrystia Freeland said. A popular tourist attraction has become the latest Chinese company to show solidarity with Huawei's chief finance officer, Meng Wanzhou, who was arrested in Canada on 1 December. Shannon Mountain Scenic Park in eastern Hainan province said it would waive the $9.65 ticket fee for anyone carrying a Huawei phone. Ms. Mann, who was given bail in Canada, faces extradition to the United States on charges of breaking Iran sanctions. Her case has upped tensions with China. U.S. Huawei phones should grant photos on the mountain, a notice on the Shannon Park's social media account said. We wish friends around the world who support Huawei success in bliss. The offer would last until 29 December, the South China Morning Post reported, but it was met with some criticism among China's social media users, who claimed it was discriminatory. Huawei phone owners are being offered other enticements too. They can get a 20% discount at a bar in Beijing. Seen in Beijing, bring a Huawei phone and get 20% off. Similar to this story we covered yesterday, https://co.qxl1iypqlpic, twitter.com/sokolov, end of Twitter post by @loshinji. At least one firm has threatened to penalize anyone buying Apple products. A few days ago, Manpada Shenzhen, based LED display manufacturer, offered subsidies to any employees buying Huawei phones. It also pledged to fine anyone who bought an Apple iPhone. United States prosecutors alleged Ms. Mann,
46,
used a Huawei subsidiary called Skycom to evade sanctions on Iran between 2009 and 2014. They also allege she publicly misrepresented Skycom as being a separate company from Huawei, and that she deceived banks about the true relationship between the two companies. Ms. Mann, who is the daughter of Huawei's founder, has denied any wrongdoing and said she will contest the allegations. Life of Huawei's high-flying heiress. The United States has been investigating the Chinese telecoms giant, the world's second largest smartphone maker, since 2016. believing that it used the Skycom to bring the United States manufacturing equipment and millions of dollars in transactions to Iran in violation of sanctions. Ms. Mann's detention comes amid an increasingly acrimonious trade dispute between Washington and Beijing. China is angry at her detention, saying she has not violated any laws. Beijing has threatened severe consequences unless Canada releases the executive. Since her arrest, two Canadians, a former diplomat and a businessman, have been detained in China on suspicion of harming national security. United States President Donald Trump said last week that he might intervene in the United States Justice Department's case against Ms. Mann if it would serve national security interests or help achieve a trade deal with China. If I think it's good for what will be certainly the largest trade deal ever made, which is a very important thing, what's good for national security, I would certainly intervene if I thought it was necessary, he told Reuters news agency. Canada reacted by urging Mr. Trump not to politicize the situation.